Doma Sports Talk Worldwide with some news from the world of boxing. So y'all know what time it is. You ain't in a rush to get concussed, baby. Now, one of the worst stories in boxing, right? I bring him up all the time. I think, you know, the whole channel is about him most of the time, but it's not. About things like this. And that's Demetrius Boo Boo Andrade, WBO middleweight champion, probably the most avoided person in fighting. But, you know, he has brethren that get avoided. Louis the Real King Kong Ortiz is in the avoided group. Guillermo Rigondeaux is in the avoided group too, right? But Demetrius Andrade is up in there, right? There's a couple of more we might be forgetting a little bit. But those three, for sure, are very avoided to the point where the whole boxing community helps, you know, people avoid them, right? And let me show how bad this guy with Demetrius Andrade. Now, he's the middleweight champion. We know last year on September, right? He had had the belt then. He was the key to having an undisputed middleweight champion with Canelo Alvarez. And everybody looked away and let Canelo go fight Kovalev in November. Not even the Mexican holiday. Everybody looked away. Well, I ain't just talking about, hey, old media, this, that, all kind of media. No one was talking about an undisputed fight in the middleweight division. I don't give a damn what nobody say. That was ridiculous. But even before that, he's been calling Canelo out in the 154 division. He was a champion there. We know that. As soon as he got stripped of the title and they gave it to Leon Smith, then Canelo fought Leon Smith, but never would fight this guy, right? So, you know, he's up in the division. Gennady Golovkin didn't fight him either. Matter of fact, he asked Gennady Golovkin to fight Gennady Golovkin because he's a softball. I'll fight you right-handed. Golovkin didn't want to do that either. So Golovkin don't want none either. And make sure this is clear before anybody starts saying, well, who he fought and this and that. I'm a champion. I've been a champion since 2013. So I shouldn't have to be talking about who I fought. You know, because when you ask that, that means he fought somebody. But it's gotten so bad that he can't get fights, right? They're just calling out ridiculous people, man. You know who he said lately? He'll fight Andy Ruiz Jr., that big dude that was weighing 283 pounds against Anthony Joshua in the second fight, was weighing close to 270 in the first fight. Matter of fact, big old dude, but he's just not tall. He said he'd get in there with him. Now, he's reasonable. He said he ain't trying to do nothing crazy, like messing with the big old tall guys and stuff like that. But a guy like that, he feels he has a chance. Now, you know, people are like, he ain't got no chance against this. Well, I'll tell you, the other Ruiz, John Ruiz, was not as bad as people try to say. Roy Jones went up there and beat John Ruiz, right? Now, Roy Jones is probably the very best fighter we've ever seen, right? He went up there and beat John Ruiz. Well, it's only John Ruiz. Yeah, wait a minute. Is Evander Holyfield awesome? Yeah, with John Ruiz, it was no separation with him and Holyfield in three fights, if I'm not mistaken. No separation at all. Draws, Ruiz 1-1, Evander Holyfield 1-1, stuff like that. No separation. And Ruiz got some more people on his resume, right? So my point is, if you're awesome, it can be done, right? The other person he tried to call out, he said, well, if I have to, I'll fight Andre Ward too. Andre Ward's two divisions higher than him, and probably right now, Andre Ward, if he's lucky, he's walking around as a cruiserweight. I think he's probably a light heavyweight, you know, probably not over 220, but he's probably in them 210s. Andre ain't trying to fight no more. But the point is, Demetrius Andre would fight him too. Andre Ward is undefeated, and he's Andre Ward, damn it. That means he's awesome. This is the kind of people that Andre got to keep calling out. Because he can't get Billy Joe Saunders. Billy Joe Saunders is either doped or doing something doped. A dopey thing he's done, you know, with the domestic violence thing. You know, he's got a screw loose. So he can't get in the ring, right? And he can't get back down to 160 or 168. I don't know what Billy Joe Saunders is going to do. Canelo just ain't never doing it. Golovkin ain't ever doing it. The man can't get a fight. So he's calling out people that's ridiculously bigger than him. That's what the world done came down to. You know, you can't get no fights, so now you got to call out just ridiculous stuff. And meanwhile, the people that we've been putting on number one pound for pound, why am I keep saying we? Bottom line, the people that will be on the number one pound for pound, their behavior is nothing close to this. Nothing close to this. The other guy in middleweight, Charlo, he's trying to go up to a super middleweight and fight the hardest guy at super middleweight. Now, the guys that are number one pound for pound lately, let's start with Golovkin, he was number one pound for pound. Right? Some people's had him there. So it's probably still a few that still have him there, but not as many as it was maybe 2 years ago. Right? Number one, pound for pound. A guy like that was saying he'd fight everybody from 154 to 175 and wasn't. That wasn't true. We've proven that. He didn't want a lot of people, including Andre Ward, but he didn't do that. Didn't want to fight Andre. Don't want to fight Charlo when he's mandated. In his last four fights, he's got Steve Rose, Vinus Monterosen in there. He fought Darren Chinko, arguably lost that. Fought Canelo, but arguably lost that, which I don't think he lost to Canelo. But my point is, anybody, every time you step up, there is no separation whatsoever. So that's why he's fighting Steve Rose. And now, right, instead of fighting Canelo, which I don't want to see, but a lot of people do, he wants to fight Zamarreta, who was not his mandatory when the negotiations start. He's hell-bent on that. He's told Canelo, no, I'm going to fight Zamarreta. Dude by 23 wins with four knockouts. We just got the fifth one recently. 20% knockout ratio. That's who he's hell-bent on fighting. Not trying to do anything significant in the middleweight division. This guy was number one pound for pound. That's the only thing, people. It's not like, oh, Golovkin, we're going in on Golovkin. Going on in Golovkin because he was number one pound for pound. Sometimes we just say that and don't realize what you're saying. That means the very best boxer on the planet. They have to have a certain decorum. They have to act a certain way. We can't have the very best boxer on the whole planet, the one we're going to send to fight the other planet. If some other planet came down here and said, send your best boxer, this is the guy we send. Right? So he has to act accordingly, don't you think? So we can't be having, hey, we don't want to fight him. He ain't going to fight him. He ain't fighting. No, you know, what the hell? Document it. So that's who we had, right? Number one, pound for pound. Another one, Lomachenko. Still, Terrence Crawford is easily number one pound for pound right now. Terrence Crawford. The guys we were talking about in the welterweight division, them dudes in the welterweight division, we're talking about all of them. Spence, Porter, Thurman, Danny Garcia, all that stuff have been there for a minute. They could have got that stuff together before Terrence Crawford got there. I was 135, the baddest dude. I was at 140, undisputed. Now I'm up here, and I got to fight the other dudes. We're talking about we in a different promotion companies and stuff, right? Terrence Crawford is number one pound for pound. Nobody about it. But Lomachenko, they put there all the time, even though Lomachenko got about 13 fights. Lost already to Salido with 13 losses, right? Been knocked down and fight with Gary Russell Jr. Been knocked down against your boy, I think his name right now. Damn it. But anyway, been knocked down a couple of times. But Lomachenko was awesome. But why do we have to put him at number one pound for pound? If so, he wouldn't be doing things like this. First of all, in that lightweight division, we could have an undisputed champion in the very next fight. Devin Haney was his mandatory. 21 years old. Devin Haney's a baby. 21 years old, man. Right? Was his mandatory. Dangerous dude. Very talented dude. This is a guy that maybe Lomachenko can't outbox. That kind of guy, like an Andre type. Well, you ain't outboxing, right? He requests from the WBC that they give him this new franchise belt that they gave Canelo, another guy we're going to talk about in a minute. He requested to have that because that belt enables you to not fight your mandatory, right? That's what Gennady Golovkin should have requested. Like, I don't want to fight Zamarreta. But first of all, they made Zamarreta the mandatory so he can call him mandatory so it doesn't look that bad. That's what really happened there. But to ask for a belt so I don't have to fight Devin Haney. Now, fighting Teofilo Lopez, who is dangerous too. I think Devin Haney's a little bit more dangerous. But Lopez will knock you out and talk a little bit more smack to you, right? You don't want to mess with Lopez neither. But they're supposed to have a fight, a very significant fight. Actually, Lomachenko should have beat Devin Haney, right? And he would have went into this fight, would have had undisputed because Lopez beat Comey. Right? So we would have had undisputed. But now it's not going to be undisputed, but it's still going to be a good fight between Lomachenko and Teofilo Lopez. Everything's good, actually. Well, not everything, because Devin Haney's not getting his shot. But it gets worse. Teofilo Lopez ready. As soon as this pandemic is over, right, let's get it on. Your boy Lomachenko, according to reports, wants a tune-up first. As the number one pound for pound, the very best fighter. Mind you, the one that we're sending to fight against the aliens, when the aliens tell us, hey, send your best boxer, this is the guy we're going to send, the number one pound for pound. He needs a tune-up to fight a 22-year-old Teofilo Lopez. And Lopez, you know what Lopez said? Hell no, you're going to be my tune-up because I'm a tune-up to fight. Maybe I'll have to fight Devin Haney after you. This is what's going on. So these are the number one pound for pounds. Now we have Canelo that's the number one pound for pound. Don't want to fight Andre in an undisputed fight. Don't want to fight Charlo when he was a mandatory, right? We still gave him that, you know, that the new created franchise title that he doesn't have to fight Charlo. Don't have to fight Andre, right? Went up to fight Rory Fielding when he went to 168 instead of one of the real guys with the real titles, not the regular title, right? These are the guys that we want to have as undisputed. And the behavior is ridiculous. The real ones, like Demetrius Andre, who's calling anybody out all kind of sizes and ridiculous sizes and stuff because he can't get a fight, that's what's going on with boxing. Actually, the undisputed middleweight champion would probably be Demetrius Andre, maybe Charlo, maybe Canelo, but we would like to see it. And if the guys that are the reasons that we can't see it, here's my issue. They should not be in front of the guys that they don't want to fight. That's where the issue is. We cannot keep putting them at number one pound for pound just because you want to and expect everybody to just believe that crap because it's not going on and it's starting to get so blatant that I think it's going to trickle down to the casuals. Let's see what happens. But that's the point. You know, Demetrius Andre, I'm going to fight Andy Ruiz Jr. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to fight Andre Ward. Man, the dude's 160 pounds, man. Came up from 154 to 160, right? Got to fight ridiculous people because, hey, I ain't getting no fights. And here's another thing. Ain't nobody telling on them, the people that won't fight them. That's what's the problem. Tell on them then and put him at number 2 pound for pound so they would have to fight him. But you're not going to do that, now are you? Doma Sports Talk, worldwide. Bam. And I'm up out of here, y'all.